Today, let's take a look at this factoring question from Reddit. We are going to factor 16x to the 4th power plus 4x squared times y squared and then plus y to the 4th power. And I'll tell you, this is a pretty hard factoring question. And I'll tell you this as well. It's possible for us to factor it and get two factors multiplying. So your answer should look like this at the end. But now, you should go ahead, pause the video and give this equation a try first before you watch the solution. So go and try it. Go and try it. Alright, done? Okay. Well, I think some of you guys might have run into trouble with this because the middle number didn't work out the way that you want it to be, right? Let me actually give you guys an easier question to look at first. Suppose we have 16x to the 4th power plus 8x squared y squared and then plus y to the 4th power. This is actually so much easier because have a look. We have a trinomial, right? First, second, and the third term. So we can try to use the tic-tac-toe method. Especially we don't have any common factors, just go ahead and try it to do this. Right? Draw the tic-tac-toe boxes first. And now ask yourself, what times 4 will give us 16x to the 4th power? Well, 4 times 4 is 16. X times x to the 3rd power, sure, that's x to the 4th. But let's try to make it more even. So x squared and x squared. This times that does give us 16x to the 4th. And then we come here and ask ourselves, what times 4 will give us y to the 4th power? Y squared times y squared. And this is perfect because take this, multiply by that, we get 4x squared y squared. And take this times that, we also get 4x squared y squared. And now make sure that you combine the middle terms and check with this right here. 4x squared y squared plus 4x squared y squared does give us the middle term. So this is the correct factoring. Yeah? And when you read the answer, you go across. We have 4x squared positive right here, so it's plus y squared multiply the same thing, 4x squared plus y squared. And of course you can write this as, because they are the same, so let's write it as 4x squared plus y squared and then squared. So think about it, is it possible for us to do the same thing right here? No, at least not yet, because right here we have a 4. We really want to have an 8 in order for this to work out the way that we want it to be, right? So, if you ran into trouble earlier, that's the reason, but don't give up. If you only have 4, why don't we give it 4 more? So this is what I mean. Look at this, go ahead and just add 4x squared y squared, but I cannot just do this to that, otherwise it changes the whole thing. It's okay if at the end we minus 4x squared y squared, because this and that same line is just equal to 0. Positive, negative cancel, just 0. Then now if you combine them, this becomes 16x to the 4th, this and that is plus 8x squared y squared, and then this right here is plus y to the 4th, and then this right here is minus 4x squared y squared. Alright? Okay, if you take a look at the first three terms, this first three terms will give us exactly this. So, let me just put that down. We will have 4x squared plus y squared, that's a plus, not t, and then square that from here. Perfect. So, this first three terms will give us a perfect square, meaning this to the second power. And then notice the best thing is this right here, we have a minus 4x squared y squared. We can also put this into a perfect square form. Let me show you. Parentheses, squared. What square give us 4? The answer is 2. What square will give us x squared? Just x. What square will give us y squared? Just y. 2xy squared give us that. And now what? We have a difference of 2 squares. We have a difference of 2 squares. Now, let me remind you guys the formula. If today we have a difference of two squares, a squared minus b squared, this factors to a, the first term, minus b, the second, times a plus b. Right? A minus b times a plus b. And now this is exactly what we have to do. Check this out. This is the a. I'm just going to write that down. We have 4x squared plus y squared. And then in the middle, we have to have the minus right here. And then the b term, which is this, 2xy. So that's the first part. And now for the second part, we pretty much do the same thing. Instead of the minus, we will have a plus. So ladies and gentlemen, here the second term is 4x squared y plus y squared, right? And then plus this right here, 2xy. Yeah, just like that. So it's factorable. Usually we like to write down the terms in the descending order with x. This is x squared, this is x to the first power, so we usually like to have this term in the middle. So I will present the final answer as here, 4x squared minus 2xy, and then plus y squared. And then this right here, we have 4x squared plus 2xy, and then plus y squared. That is it. Right? That's it.